I can't even figure out how to actually open this box here initially, because it looks like it's so well done. By the way, this is my favorite box opener, or box cutter. It's using a ceramic type of plastic and it normally works, but it actually doesn't work on this one here. How on earth do you even open this thing? I guess a box cutter is not really working on this one here. Hold on. Let's see here. I see. I actually needed to turn around. If you look down here, there's a smart part. Okay, that makes sense. Duh. I don't think I'm gonna need a box cutter. Let's see here. And it's heavy, by the way. This box here right now is about 60, 70 pounds. That's how you unbox. Okay. All right, another box. Beautiful. Oh yeah, I heard about this. If you look over here, it's got these parts here, and we'll figure out how that works. Let's see here. It's definitely not like this. It's not here either. I heard about these, and I can't remember what to do. You have to take these things out here, and then you do it on the other side too, I suppose. Here, and then do you lift? Oh my god, that's how it works. Okay, now it's starting to make sense. And then this thing here comes out, and then you get some accessories. We can get back to that later. The keyboard as well, and there's a few more things down here. Oh, power cable. And a manual that I'm never gonna read. And I think that's it. This is what it looks like down here. So everything is like neatly put into these pockets, and the manual here, the wire. Wow, this is actually the easiest unboxing ever. It looks so complicated, but okay, perfect. Let's get this out of the way. Okay. And then I suppose with this stuff here, it's just pretty much. I'm sure there's a way more elegant way to get it off, but. Oh, you can, duh. Look at this, so funny actually. No, I'm making like all the errors in terms of how to unbox it over here. Okay, so beautiful. And then this thing here. Oh, so beautiful. That, gotta say, like this cheese grater stuff here looks absolutely beautiful. Check it out. All right, cool. It's time to get in the studio. Let's get it up and running. I'll see you in there. You got like a 56 core PC and then the Mac side by side. I'm gonna be using both because we're working on technology that runs on both platforms, and it's gonna be really, really interesting doing a benchmark comparison between the two. And mine came with a couple of different accessories here. The power wire is kind of interesting. It has this weird sort of felt on it. Okay, so before we go any further, just check out the sound here. Let me just put the microphone really close to the computer so you can hear here. This is the general noise in the room right now. I'm gonna go ahead and switch the PC off, and then let's see what it sounds like here. Let's just do it here. You're not supposed to switch a PC off this way, but. And now there's virtually no sound. The Mac is on, it's just completely silent. It's freaking amazing. So in this video, I'm not really gonna go into the sort of traditional unboxing. There's a million different videos doing that.
I just want to focus on the digital audio workstation aspect of the new Mac Pro and why I picked the particular cores and RAM and all that stuff. A lot of people have been asking about it, and we got some questions on Facebook that I'm going to address at the end of this video as well, that all relate to the same thing, like what system should I choose, 24, 28, 16 cores. And long story short, I've been super fortunate to work with a couple of people that are very close to this project that helped guide me through which particular Mac to select for my needs, and I'm just gonna try to express that in this video. So I'm on a 16 core, 384 gigabytes, 4 terabytes system here on the new Mac. And the reasoning behind it is really, I like a fast workflow. I don't like when things get sluggish, and I don't necessarily need like 1,000 tracks in my computer. If you're really like heavy on your template and you want it all in one computer, it's probably better to consider 24 or 28 cores, but the downside is that they're not as fast. So for me, I'm probably not gonna do more than like 200 tracks, and that can really be accommodated within the 16 core sort of architecture. They're notably faster, and for me, that's better. Some VSTs are heavy, some plugins are heavy, so that all runs a little more smoothly. And on top of that, I'm actually running a 56 core PC, and my guess is, I'm not gonna do benchmark testing right now, I'll do another video for that, that it might actually not be that different from the 16 core Mac. And one of the beautiful things about Mac is that they do first party optimization, in particular between their software and hardware. So programs like Final Cut or LogicX are all super optimized to the hardware. So for that reason, it's a joy. And for that reason, it also helps, for me at least, when you get the 16 cores, like super, super fast performance. If I can't make great music with that, including legato and orchestration and all that with 16 cores, I think it's on me more than anyone else to blame the outcome of that. And if I ever needed that big sort of orchestration, massive 1,000, 2,000 track template, I can always connect a PC or two through VE Pro or other tools like that. But for me, I love working in the box. I love having a unified, fast workflow and environment. And this was the right choice for me. So 16 cores, 384 gigabytes, I think it is. Also got the Vega graphics card, the Duo 2, which is a 32 gigabyte graphics card. So there's no nonsense with video editing and all that stuff. I also ordered the Pro Display. It hasn't arrived yet. So right now I'm using my LG 27 4K monitor, which is just my PC monitor as well. I actually voted to get the non-nano coated display. This monitor behind me also has the nano coating. It's great if you have a lot of reflective light coming in and you want to sort of muffle that a bit, but I find that the light is not necessarily the same as it is with a more glossy screen. You can walk into an Apple store and try to compare the two. It's not exactly the same. I personally prefer more light and even the sort of bright glossiness of the screen. I'm totally cool with that. Oh, and on top of that, I also decided not to get the fancy, beautiful arm that's behind. As you can see, there's a wall behind me, so nobody can see from behind, but I actually wanted more control. So I ended up getting an ergonomic arm that's connected to a VESA mount, so I can pull the monitor any way I want. I personally prefer that sort of level of flexibility, and it's notably cheaper as well. So long story short, 16 core for me is the perfect sweet spot for hybrid orchestral kind of composition. I get the speed, the fast speed, which improves my workflow and lessens the time it takes to create stuff. I can always hook a PC up if I want to do that and get my orchestration going. But again, if you're super serious, having a one box, super crazy template environment, 24 or 28 is probably better for you. And for me, like 384 gigabytes should be enough. The RAM slots are actually not fully utilized. I'm only utilizing half of them, so you can pretty much double up and all that. So we also got a bunch of questions on Facebook. I'm gonna address some of them here. Some of them are absolutely hilarious. Peter Schlosser writes, what were the terms of your mortgage to buy this machine? It's crazy how expensive it is. And yeah, it is crazy how expensive it is. So was my PC. I think anytime you venture into these sort of pro level computers, it gets expensive. I don't think we always need it. I've seen some of the best stuff done on way older computers without like this much processing power. It's all about the minds that create it. But for me, what I appreciate about these fast computers is just that it improves my workflow. It cuts down on time, so it's just more effective to work on them. Carrie is asking, how many software instrument tracks can you fit into a DAW with reverbs and everything with 500 gigabytes plus RAM before it hiccups? We're gonna find out. I'm not gonna address that in this video here. There's some preliminary tests out there that are absolutely crazy. If you watched Apple at the WWDC where David Earls took this whole massive template and ran it through, it was pretty impressive what it can handle. I heard someone the other day talk about like 80 chromaverbs at the same time. I don't really think that processing is a problem unless you go absolutely crazy. But for me, you know, some of the best music is made with 10, 12 tracks. We don't need more always, you know? Chris Bacon is asking, can you reliably run a robust everything system on one computer, or will you still need to separate into different machines using B Pro? I've actually run on one computer for a long time. That's why I have this beefy PC. I absolutely am gonna do the same thing here. I don't think we need these massive setups. I go way back to having 9 computers. Back in the day, I had 2 computers designated for strings, brass, woodwinds, percussion, and additional one for choir. But right now I can run it all on one computer. So again, I think it comes more back to like the limitations of our minds more than technology. We can't really blame the technology anymore. It's so awesome. Lee Blasky is asking, I'm curious to know the difference in performance between a 16 core and a 28 core for audio and music use. Does the faster process speed on the 16 core have the edge for audio, or is it better to have the maximum amount of cores? I wanna say if you really wanna push it and you want that plus 1,000 track template, you should probably consider the 20 or the 24. But I think like for me, and I'll definitely put this one to the test, that 16 cores is sort of the optimal sweet spot unless you wanna go super heavy. But if you wanna go super heavy, you probably have a VE Pro set up anyway right now where you're daisy chaining a couple of PCs either to your Mac or another PC. That would probably be the way to resolve that. But personally, I love working inside of the box. It really improves the time it takes to make composition. I always have issues with network and all that. There's always something wrong. It doesn't sync the right way or whatever, but that's just me. There are pros and cons to all these decisions, but we're getting pretty close to be able to run everything inside of the machine. And God forbid we had to render all these tracks and then compose on top of them like we did in the old days. I don't think that's gonna happen. I haven't done it for years. And I love pushing computers. It's like part of my part-time hobby. And again, I would really consider the ratio of cores to the power you actually get out of it and whether it's optimized or not. In this case, I'm gonna be running Logic predominantly and Final Cut, all first party software, all super optimized to the hardware. If you run other things, you may not get the same level of optimization, but with 16 cores, with Logic Pro completely designed for it, I think it's gonna be a blast. But that doesn't mean I'm gonna abandon PC, by the way. I absolutely love my PC and I love Mac as well. I love them equally. I think PC is offering a lot more diversity sometimes. You can get more obscure plugins. You may not always get the performance you get on Mac, but you can get more cores and so forth, and it's not as expensive. On the other hand, with Mac, you get all the first party optimization. So, you know, there are pros and cons to both of these things, but what a beautiful world we live in. We could do anything we want at this point. Like, these things are so potent. And Clement is actually talking about some of the same things here. He says, Lee Blasky, most DAWs aren't well optimized for multi-core work. 28 core and such is perfect for 3D work and computation. In the audio world, it's still more a matter of real-time performance and speed rather than power. Fast single core speed is always preferable to slow cores. That said, the 12 and 16 cores seems to be the sweet spot of all that and money-wise. And I agree with that. That's sort of my thinking as well. It is the sweet spot. You get the maximum performance if you want a fast workflow and everything just running super fast. You may not be able to do like 1,000 tracks at the same time, but how often do we really do that as well? So anyway, this was just a little blurb about this. I'm gonna do some more videos as we get into it and I start installing stuff, and let's really push this computer to the absolute max and see what it's made out of and compare it to the PC as well. I have 2 amazing systems side by side, and it could be interesting to really take a power PC and match it against a powerful Mac as well. So anyway, thanks for watching.